Question number 20. The figure below represents a flower garden in the shape of a triangle and a semicircle. So we have the triangle and the semicircle. What is the area of the garden? So the area of the garden is, we can get the area of the garden because this is an irregular shape. An irregular shape is a shape where you cannot use one formula to calculate the area. So you calculate the area of the triangle and the area of the semicircle, and we add. So this means that area is equals to the area of a triangle is a half, the base is 8 and the height is 6, that is to give us the area of a triangle, plus to get the area of the semicircle we need the radius. And we use the Pythagoras theorem to find the diameter. So D is equals to Pythagoras theorem. It is a square root of 8 squared plus 6 squared. So this is a square root of 64 plus 36 squared, which is a square root of 100, which is equals to 10. So the diameter is equals to, the diameter is 10, meaning that the radius is 5 centimeter. So you get the area of the semicircle is a half, 22 over 7 multiplied by r squared, which is 5 multiplied by 5. So this you can simplify, you can divide by 2, you get 4, implying that here you get 4 times 6, that will give you 24, plus here you can simplify, you get 11. So this means that 25 times 11, we can use a section here, 25 times, this is 5 times 5 times 11, that will give us 25, so this is 275. So this means you'll be able to get 275, you divide by 7, which is equals to 24. You add, you can divide this by 7, you get by 7, this is 3 is for 21, so we have 6, so 65, you divide by 7, you get 63, which is 9, and we'll be left with 2 out of 7 when you divide that. So when you add 24 and you add 39, you can add 4, 24 and 39, that will give us 3, carry 1, that is 63. So you'll be able to get this is 63 and 2 over 7. So if you check, this will mean that meter squared, because that is a unit of our measurements. So if you check the answers, you find out that C is a correct answer. So always work out a question, then you check the answer, because some of the answers that are given in the four answers are part of what you have worked out, part of the outcomes you have, and they will confuse you. Question number 20. The figure below represents a flower garden in the shape of a triangle and a semicircle. So we have the triangle and the semicircle. What is the area of the garden? So the area of the garden is, we can get the area of the garden because this is an irregular shape. An irregular shape is a shape where you cannot use one formula to calculate the area. So you calculate the area of the triangle and the area of the semicircle, and we add. So this means that area is equals to the area of a triangle is a half, the base is 8 and the height is 6, that is to give us the area of a triangle, plus to get the area of the semicircle we need the radius. And we use the Pythagoras theorem to find the diameter. So D is equals to Pythagoras theorem, it is a square root of 8 squared plus 6 squared. So this is a square root of 64 plus 36, that is 6 squared, which is a square root of 100, which is equals to 10. So the diameter is equals to, the diameter is 10, meaning that the radius is 5 centimeter. So you get the area of the semicircle is a half, 22 over 7 multiplied by r squared, which is 5 multiplied by 5. So this you can simplify, you can divide by 2, you get 4, implying that here you get 4 times 6, that will give you 24 plus. Here you can simplify, you get 11. So this means that 25 times 11, we can use a section here. 25 times, this is 5 times 5 times 11, that will give us 25, so this is 5, 7, 275. So this means you'll be able to get 275, you divide by 7, which is equals to 24, you add, you can divide this by 7, you get by 7, this is 3 is for 21, so we have 6, so 65, you divide by 7, you get 63, which is 9, and we'll be left with 2 out of 7, when you divide that. So when you add 24, and you add 39, you can add 4, 24 and 39, that will give us 3, carry 1, that is 63. So you'll be able to get this is 63 and 2 over 7. So if you check, this will mean that meter squared, because that is a unit of our measurements. So if you check the answers, you'll see, you find out that C is a correct answer. So always work out a question, then you check the answer, because some of the answers that are given in the four answers are part of what you have worked out, part of the outcomes you have, and they will confuse you.